Hey guys, what is up? Eric Merced here, and today I am going to be starting a new series called Manga Studio Basics, in where I go through basic simple stuff for beginners, and I'll talk about, you know, basic things on how to get started in Manga Studio, some of the preferences that you can choose to toggle on or off, and some of the things that I do to help me get work done faster and with less fussing in Manga Studio. Now today I want to speak about keeping your artwork organized inside of Manga Studio. And just like Photoshop, Manga Studio has this feature where you can take all your layers and put them inside of folders. And the great thing about that is you can have as many folders as you want, and you can put in as many layers as you want. Now, in this image of Batgirl that I did back in 2014, you're going to see here at the layers pane that I have a couple of folders set up. First of all, I have my basic default background color, which you can toggle on and off, and it really won't affect anything because of the way I've had this set up in the coloring stage. But I do have a folder for color where all of my color layers are in. And I have a textures layer where all my textures are placed in, as well as a line art folder and a selections folder. Now if we go back to the colors folder here and we just open it up, we're gonna see all of my colored layers are in there, including my flats and some of the effects that I've added onto the coloring stage. And I also have a folder within the colors folder, which is also another great thing, that you can create folders and basically nest them within other folders. That's pretty cool. And within this color folder, I have the shades folder. Basically, that's where I've done all of my shadows. Now, if I go and toggle this visibility off on this, you're gonna see here on the image how all of my shading disappears. Let me toggle it back on and off. All right, and this is a really great way to organize yourself. Let me go ahead and toggle off the flats right there. Toggle off a couple of these so you can just see basically the changes that I've done to this image. That's my flats right there, and then my shading and my color. And if I toggle off the visibility on the color, I'll be left with my black and white image. So a really cool thing to do when you're basically working inside of Manga Studio, or even inside of Photoshop, is to get into the habits of creating folders for your layers so you can keep yourself organized as you go along. And this is great because let's say you need a black and white version of this image, like I showed you earlier, you can just go ahead and toggle off the color folder and you'll instantly have a black and white version of that image. Or let's say you need just a flat colored version of that image without the shading. Again, you can go into your shades and folder and toggle it off, and there you go. You have, and maybe even toggle these off, these effects off, and you'll have a flat colored image that you can use. So being organized with folders, it's really great. You can create, for example, a highlights folder. You can create a text folder where you'll have any dialogue that you create for the image. And you know, the possibilities are endless in doing this. I really recommend that as you work in Manga Studio or Photoshop, you get into the habit of creating folders and putting your layers inside those folders. It's going to make your life much easier to work inside that app, and it's going to make it much easier to go back and work on edits or on different multiple versions of the image that you're working on in the future. So thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed and you want to, you know, keep up to date with new videos as I post them, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I'm going to appreciate it. Thanks for watching. And if you have any comments, please leave them in the comment section. I will see you in the next one.